Before that, Erypatria japonica has been, several people work on this plant, work on the ethanolic and methanolic extracts, where they showed inhibition in liver fibrosis, and also it contains polyphenolic antioxidants that suppress some low density lipoprotein oxidation. Also, the seeds of this plant exerted a hypoglycemic property because of it contains catechin, epicatechin, epallocatechin. And also, we done this, we isolated synchronine from this plant that showed also an insulinotropic effect. It can enhance insulin. This was published in 2009. Also, extensive work has been done on this, the triprene acids of this leaves as antiviral, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, anti-mutagenic, anti-tumoral properties. So this basically led us to work on this. So what we started with is just get the extract, boil it for a while, and get the hydrophilic extract, not the ethanolic or methanolic extract. So just the water extract, and we mix that with human blood that are then we stimulated those blood cells with PHA and MPS as major stimulant of cytokines, and we found out that this hydrophilic extract enhances the production of interleukin 12. Interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor, but did not affect interleukin 10. This is, of course, with the stimulation of PHA and MPS. So the idea was to see if this extract really modulates the cytokine production. So the next step, or the next question, was does this extract reverses hydrocortisone suppressive activity of on the inflammatory cytokines. So we've done that, and this is basically, it doesn't show, but this is a significant effect here, here, and here. And the hydrophilic extract reversed the hydrocortisone effect at this concentration, especially for interleukin 12, interferon gamma, and tumor necrosis factor, but did not on interleukin 10. So the third question was, does this extract enhance or induce the secretion of cytokines without having a PHA or MPS? And this is a comparison to PHA and MPS. You can see at very low levels, it then increases the production of interleukin 12, interferon gamma, and tumor necrosis factor, and at higher concentrations, interleukin 10 starts to go up at 100 microgram per ml. So in conclusion of this, basically, Erypatria induces pro-inflammatory cytokines at lower concentrations, and it induces anti-inflammatory like interleukin 10 at higher concentrations. We've done another experiment that was published that this Erypatria japonica increases nucleus factor, NF-kappa B translocation in the nucleus, which indicates that one of the partial activities is on NF-kappa B activation. The next work that we've done is on mice by injecting several concentrations of this hydrophilic extract and also another extract, or another fraction, which we call water residue. What we've done with that is when we've took this hydrophilic, we treated it with butanol, and then we eliminated the less polar compounds, and we took the high polar compounds from the butanol extraction, and we also used that to see which is better in stimulating cytokines at this level. So we injected either this or that in mice, and we checked the spleen, the blood, and the lungs. Basically, we took the spleen or the lungs and we did a homogenization of the tissues, and then we measured the cytokines. As you can see, there is increasing the screen of interferon gamma with the two allopatrias, water extract or water residue, and there is suppression of TGF beta for the water residue only, whereas the did not affect TGF beta, and interleukin 17 also was increased. In the blood, there is a suppression of TGF beta, and the other tissues did not show any kind of effect. So the next step was we want to see this kinetics of this water residue or Areopagitica hydrophilic extract in mice. So we injected the mice with 10 micrograms of these and 2 micrograms of LPS. LPS increased within 6 hours, but the Areopagitica decreased interferon gamma in the spleen after 24 hours and stayed for 48 hours. What about TGF? TGF, the same thing. It lowered TGF beta in time specific manner, also about 24 hours of after injection. The third question in this respect was whether if we have a tumor model, and this tumor model, subcutaneous tumor like MCA fibrosarcoma, which we induced in DALC mice, if this injection of EGE hydrophilic or the water residue can modulate the cytokines in the tumor microenvironment. So in the tumor microenvironment, it doesn't say here, but this is the tumor microenvironment, that this is the control, the tumor by itself, but a single injection versus triple injections of the areopotrials, we can see that interferon gamma did increase after triple injections. Each injection was 24 hours apart, and we've done this, and this was significant with the water residue. And also, for unknown reasons, also TGF also increased while we injected this after triple injection. Interleukin 17, this was the same thing, that it increased also after triple injection with the water, after the water residue administration. So this is, if we look at the spleen, TGF to interferon gamma ratio in healthy versus tumor-bearing mice. In healthy, the TGF beta to interferon was 300. It went down to 36 and then 26 ratio. This in healthy mice, whereas in the tumor bearing, the level stayed high, except were a little bit lower after triple injection. So this means that we have some kind of resistance in this type of immunomodulation. So after that, we thought about, okay, let's do this using this Areopotria hydrophilic and the water residue, if it can basically prolong or enhance the tumor survival of a tumor of mice that has intraperitoneal model of MCA fibrosarcoma. And the results were the control and the Areopotria japonica hydrophilic extract did not show any difference, whereas the water residue, there are some enhancement of that. So basically, after this, we thought, okay, we know that this will not be a good therapeutic agent for cancer. So we thought, of course, of mixing that with another cytotoxic drug. And the choice was on doxorubicin. Doxorubicin, as all you know, is most effective and high potency anti-cancer drug. It works against leukemias, lymphomas, carcinomas, and soft tissues, sarcomas. This is the doxorubicin structure, and the mechanism of action, as all everybody we talked, there are a lot of talks about it. It does DNA percolation and inhibiting the topoisomerase, resulting in the DNA strand breaks. Also, it activates caspases like 3 that cleaves the PARP, resulting in DNA fragmentation. The last important thing with that dox was found to modulate cytokines. And this is another thing research has been coming on this, that it does modulate cytokine production. However, DOX has adverse effects, as just the previous lecture. It causes cardiac effects and dilation of cardiomyopathy. This dose-dependent reduction in mitochondrial oxidative phosphorylation reaction results in the reactive oxygen species causing heart cell damage, as you've been seeing just in the previous lecture. Now, the question is, we want to add those together and see their effect in vitro on first on spleen cells. So mixing doxorubicin, Areopagitica japonica, different concentrations. This is in micromolar, this is microgram per ml. And the, both of them, as you can see, the doxorubicin does some toxic effect on the spleen cells. It dropped to 80%, whereas the Areopagitica did not affect that much. And the combination showed better, as it seems it's a protective effect. In MCA fibrosarcoma with Areopagitica, Areopagitica was mixed with the MCA fibrosarcoma. It shows very low survival, or very low toxicity, sorry. But when we, this was mixed with the spleen cells from tumor-bearing mice, the Areopagitica hydrophilic water residue showed a very toxicity to the MCA fibrosarcoma. What about doxorubicin? Doxorubicin also when it has toxic effect on the cancer itself, it went down to about 60% at higher concentration. But when it is mixed with the spleen cells, the toxicity at this end was significantly higher than this, indicating that there is a modulation of cytokines that enhances spleen cells to kill the MCA fibrosarcoma. What about if we mixed the three together in without spleen, just MCA fibrosarcoma? This is the DOX, this is the Areopagitica water residue, and the combination was no, there was no synergistic or additive effect, so it is the same. So then we mixed this with spleen cells from tumor-bearing mice, and you can see there is the survival with both of them were good, and but the mixture of those did not show any significant or additive effect with them. So we thought that this might be with a different type of, what we took spleen cells as a whole. Let's talk, take a fraction of the immune cells that we worked on natural killer isolation from spleen cells of tumor-bearing mice. And as you can see with NK cells, the mixture both showed basically some significant than both of them, than either one of them, sorry. This is a slide to show that if the NK cells from healthy mice versus tumor-bearing mice, that there is the NK cells has good activity when they are healthy. When they are from tumor-bearing, there is less active. And with doxorubicin, basically the activity is lost. But at higher concentration of doxorubicin, both of them, the healthy versus the tumor-bearing NK cells showed similar activity. Now, getting all the things together with MCA, MCA tumor-bearing NK cells versus doxorubicin and everything, so the mixture of those at 1 microgram with 5 micromolar dox or 10 with 5 molar dox showed a significant effect than either one alone. So the next question on this regard, does it this related or associated with NK cytokine modulation or not? So we tested this, of course, on two cytokines, on interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor alpha. And we showed this with MDA from tumor-bearing and healthy spleen cells with MCA. As you can see, doxorubicin by itself, it has immunomodulation in health, from healthy mice, healthy spleen or NK cells. It enhances interferon gamma. But with NK cells for tumor-bearing, there is drop, and so this is not a significant modulation. When we mix that with erythromelalgia, there is a very high response from healthy mice, healthy NK cells, but not from the tumor-bearing NK cells. What about tumor necrosis factor? Tumor necrosis factor, there is doxorubicin enhanced tumor necrosis factor at these concentrations. Those three were all significantly more than this. And when we mix that with erythromelalgia, the enhancement was also significant in the NK cells from tumor bearing and also from healthy mice. So in conclusion, doxorubicin increased TNF production in MCA-stimulated tumor-bearing NK cells. Erythromelalgia increased significantly TNF production in MCA NK cells in MCA tumor-bearing mice. The combination increased TNF more than either one alone, whereas did not affect, so dox did not modulate production of MCA from simulated healthy or tumor-bearing NK cells. Erythromelalgia increased interferon gamma production from NK cells isolated from pre-healthy but not from the tumor-bearing gamma. The combination did not do much. So in conclusion, what docs showed mild and moderate toxicity to the spleen and the MCA fibrosarcoma respectively, docs cytotoxicity on MCA fibrosarcoma increased when co-cultured with spleen cells, indicating that this is due to a cytokine modulation by DOX and similarly by erythromelalgia water residue. Cytokine modulatory effects produced from spleen cells and NK cells induced by DOX and erythromelalgia water residue is shown to be essential in enhancing killing of MCA fibrosarcoma. So what is further studies on the future is we would like to work on the blocking specific signaling of SMAD to reduce TGF-beta because DOX was not shown to affect TGF-beta whether in spleen cells from healthy or tumor-bearing mice. So we've done that already, but I did not show this. So we'd like to work on this by inhibiting SMAD in order to reduce TGF-beta in the tumor microenvironment and, of course, secondary lymphoid organs by the spleen. And this hopefully will enhance the activity of DOX with the erythromelalgia and reduce toxicity of to normal tissues and especially might be the heart. My research team includes Dayali and Maisa Hanbali, Hiba Shakir, Marwatan. All of these are graduate students. Those all are graduated. I have those two graduate students. Nada is working now on the subfractioning and affecting on the immunomodulation of these extracts. And my collaborators are Professor Fadil Madan is a biochemist, and Bofir Hussaini Nada Nizar Finland are pharmacologists. Our grants are limited from Georgia.